大家好，欢迎大家收听今天的早安英文，我是卡拉。
I am Joseph.
今天要和大家分享一些 collocation, 叫做搭配词。
Right, if you want your English to sound more natural, you really should avoid Chinglish.
对，很多人因为受到强大的中式思维的影响啊，使得英文当中有一些用词呢，会出现不恰当，甚至是错误的一些搭配。
The other day, I had one of my students say, spread perfume.
其实我还挺能理解他的，因为喷香水就是感觉spread it all over. 但是喷香水擦香水我们会讲 wear, 或者呢就喷这个动作我们会用 spray, 但是呢不会用 spread 这个词啊。
Wear, for where you can wear a hat.
就是戴帽子。
Wear glasses.
就戴眼镜。
Wear gloves.
戴手套。
Wear sunscreen.
这个 sunscreen 是防晒霜啊，所以擦防晒霜也是用这个。
Or wear makeup.
包括化妆，就是说今天是带妆出门哦，我们就讲 wear makeup. 所以今天呢，要教大家纠正这些可能会用错的动名词搭配。
So the first one is, we drink soup, not usually eat soup. It depends on if there's something in the soup. So if the soup is very light and just has flavor but no vegetables or meat, you can use drink.But if it has lots of things in it, then you should use eat, because you can't drink a solid thing.
就是我们在中文当中啊，只要是和汤相关的，不管是浓汤还是清汤，甚至是粥，我们都会用喝。那么翻译成英文就是 drink, 对不对？所以照理来想，你好像会讲 drink porridge, 但是呢，其实不是的。在英文当中，你这个是用喝还是用吃呢？依据这个汤的浓度来定的。比较浓的汤呢，我们就会用 eat。如果说比较清的汤，寡淡的汤呢，就会用 drink.
And speaking of eat soup and thick soup, 浓汤, we have not thick tea, but strong tea.
就是我们可以讲 thick soup, 可以讲浓汤，但是呢，却不能讲 thick tea 来表示浓茶. Guess it's because tea is a kind of drink, and we usually use strong and weak to describe the concentration of drinks.
Right, another strongly concentrated drink would be strong alcohol.
Yeah, 所以呢烈酒啊我们也不会讲什么 wild alcohol, 会用的是这个 strong, 因为我们通常都会用 strong 和 weak 来表示这个饮料就是这个饮品的浓度。所以呢浓茶是 strong tea, 反过来淡茶叫做 weak tea.
Another collocation that I think is interesting is raise an application should be submit an application.
我们在课上总是会和同学强调啊，最好结合中文释义和英文释义来认识新的英文单词，因为用中文来解释英文的话，有的时候就是会产生这样的误会。 I can totally understand it when Chinese people saying raise an application because in every English Chinese dictionary raise equals 提出，然后我们会说提出申请。
I suggest people use English to help understand new English words.
对，就是 raise 呢，它的确是有提出的意思，但是呢，一般我们讲这个 raise a question, 提出问题，或者 raise a request, 提出要求等等。
Right, and if you can't remember the word submit, for submit an application, you could also say to file an application, to make an application, or send in the application.
反正不是 raise an application 就对了。下一个吹长笛，怎么说？我觉得 Joseph 也还是蛮老司机的。看到在聊到这个话题的时候，就是一股难以言喻的笑啊。Can you understand it if I say blow a flute?
I can understand you, but I wouldn't say that myself.
Okay, 我们应该讲 play 啊 ，play the flute.
Right, play all kinds of instruments. Play a piano, play a trumpet, play the drum.Play can work for any kind of musical instrument.
对，就是不管是吹打还是弹乐器呢，我们一律用 play. 然后还要注意不要把中间这个冠词给落掉了。我们要讲 play the drum 或者 play the piano 或者 play a flute. 总之呢，中间不能连冠词。下一个我经常听到别人说的叫做 rush a plane.
It's not rush a plane, but have a plane to catch.
对，所以和朋友一起出去旅行啊，赶航班的时候，如果朋友慢吞吞的，你就可以说 Hurry up, we've got a plane to catch. 就是说快点快点，我们要赶飞机呢。
You can also say, Sorry, I have to go catch a plane. I need to leave now.
再比如说你在闲聊着的时候，然后呢你急着走，你可以这么说，不好意思啊，我要赶飞机，我现在就得走了。
Catch a train, catch a taxi, catch a boat. As long as it's some kind of transportation, you need to catch it.
再补充一句，其实不仅是飞机，比如说 train 或者 taxi, 我们都可以用 catch 这个词来搭配。 最后一个呢，关于存钱，要区分一下一个 save money， 一个 deposit money。
Right, they almost mean the same thing. It's just deposit means put. So deposit money at the bank just means put the money into the bank. Maybe you are putting it from one account to another and you're moving it. You're going to deposit it into the new account. But save money would be deposit the money into your account to save it for the future.
就这个 save money 呢，准确来讲，我们翻译成这个，把钱省下来，存好，放好 ，save for the future。所以呢，我们觉得翻译成省钱的话会更加的恰当。而我们平时把钱存进银行的时候，只是把它放在那里，暂时放在银行，对不对？所以用 deposit 这个动词呢，会更加恰当一点 ，deposit some money in the bank。所以呢，今天跟大家聊的这一些名词和动词之间的搭配啊，大家一定要记得不要被自己的中式思维给影响了。再重复一次，结合中英文词典去认识新的英文单词。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
我是卡拉
And I'm Joseph.
我们下次再见咯。
See you in the future.
Bye bye.